Welcome to Architech. This is Ritesh Srinivasan. In this video, I'll be explaining about stemming and lemmatization in the context of natural language processing. I'll also explain how you can do stemming and lemmatization using NLTK and SPACY libraries in Python. If you are new here and like such content, please subscribe to the channel. Let's get started. Stemming and lemmatizations are two steps which are done in the pre-processing stage of an NLP pipeline. So stemming usually refers to the crude heuristic process which kind of chops off ends of words in the hope of achieving this goal correctly most of the time, and it often includes the removal of derivational affixes. So simply put, if you have the words argue, argued, argues, arguing, and argus, the stemming algorithm or the stemmer would convert them to the stem argue. Okay. If you have words like cats, cat-like, catty, then it stems it to the word cat. So basically what happens over here is that the suffixes are kind of removed over here, right? Similarly, fishing, fish, and fisher is converted to the stem fish. So what can happen is at times during the stemming process, after removing the derivational affixes, you might get a word which is not present in the dictionary or which is not present in the language. Okay. So one of the most popular stemming algorithms is Porter Stemmer. You can look at this particular link to get more details about Porter Stemmer. So Porter Stemmer has a set of rules which it applies on a word to remove the affixes. Okay. Now let us look at what is lemmatization. So lemmatization refers to doing things properly with the use of vocabulary and morphological analysis of word. Okay. It is normally done to remove inflectional endings only, and to return to the base or dictionary form of a word, which is known as lemma. So for example, in many languages, words appears in several inflected forms. For example, in English, the verb to walk may appear as walk, walk, walks, or walking. The base form of this is walk. You can look up this in a dictionary. So this base form of these words, which is walk over here, is called as the lemma for the word. Okay. And typically the association of the base form of the word with a part of speech, for example, noun or verb or something, is also called as a lexeme of the word. Okay. So lemmatization tries to actually get to the root of the word. Okay. But in a different way compared to stemming, because here we are looking at the use of a vocabulary and morphological analysis of words. Okay. Now let us see the differences between lemmatization and stemming. So what happens in lemmatization? It actually depends on correctly identifying the intended part of the speech and meaning of a word in a sentence. Okay. As well within the larger context surrounding that sentence, such as neighboring sentences or even an entire document. So you are trying to find the root word, okay, by looking at the context, why I trying to identify the part of the speech and the meaning of the word, okay. Whereas a stemmer would operate on a single word. It doesn't have the knowledge of the context, and it cannot discriminate between words with which have different meanings depending upon part of speech and context. Okay. But stemmers are typically easier to implement and they run faster. Now let us look at the differences between lemmatization and stemming using examples. Okay. For example, the word better has good as its lemma. Okay. But if you were to give it to a stemmer, it could give something like BETT. Okay, or it could give the word better itself, because in stemming you don't have a dictionary lookup. Okay, now for the word walk, it is the word walk is actually the base form for the word walking. Okay, and even both in say a stemmer or lemmatization, you would get the root word as walk or the base word as walk for walking. Okay, now If you take a word like meeting, okay, so it can be either the base form of a noun or a form of verb which is to meet, right? It depends on the context. For example, in our last meeting, okay, it's actually a noun. We are meeting again tomorrow, it becomes a verb, right? So here, to meet, if you take the root, it should be actually to meet, okay? So unlike stemming, lemmatization attempts to select the correct lemma depending upon the context, okay? So these are the differences between lemmatization and stemming, and both are used in the pre-processing stage in the natural language processing pipeline to extract the root word or the base word for the words, okay? Because different words may mean the same thing, and the same word can be told in different ways, okay? So you are trying to actually normalize the words to reduce the variation in terms of expression of words. Let us look at how we can do stemming using NLTK package. First, we import the NLTK library. So after that, we need to check if all NLTK packages are installed for stemming. So for that, you can do NLTK download, and you can download all the packages. This needs to be done only once. Okay. Then from NLTK stem, we import the Porter stemmer, and we also import the word tokenize when we have to deal with sentences. Basically, we have to convert a sentence into tokens. There we need this word tokenizer. So here what we do is that after this we instantiate a Porter stemmer object. Okay, here we have the words which are input over here. So we have cats, catty, cat like, kittens. So let us loop through these words and let us run the stem Porter stemmer on them and see what is the stem of these words. So if you see over here, the stem of cats is cat. The stem of catty is catty with the I. There is no search word in the dictionary. Similarly, cat-like becomes cat-like. It has removed the suffix, right? Kittens has become kitten. So if you look at this, only cat and kitten are valid words in the dictionary. The other words are not valid words. This is a problem with the stemmer, that sometimes you get the stem as a word which is not present in the vocabulary or not present in the dictionary. Okay, now let us again look at another pair of words over here, computer and compute. So if you see over here, computer has become compute and compute also has become compute. Again, this word is not present in the dictionary, right? So you are actually now seeing some disadvantages of the stemmer. Okay, now let us look at another example over here where you have programmer, programs and program. Program has a different meaning altogether when compared to programs and programmer. Let us see what happens when we apply the stemmer on these words. So if you see over here, programmer has become program. Basically, it has removed the suffix over here, er. Similarly, program has again become program, P-R-O-G-R-A-M-M. Programs is correctly stemmed to program, but these two words are not present in the dictionary, right? Now there is this other stemmer in NLTK called as snowball stemmer, okay, which has an implementation of Porter stemmer also, and it has for many other languages as well. Now let us use snowball stemmer. For this, we import the snowball stemmer and then we create a stemmer object over here, snowball stemmer. Again, we pass the same set of words, which is cats, catty, cat-like, kittens. Again, the same problems are seen over here. Cats and kittens have been correctly converted to their stem, whereas these words are incorrect. Let us again try with the programmer, programs, and program and programs. Okay, the same problem is also seen over here. Okay, so this is about stemmer. So basically, we are used a stemmer to get the root. Okay, so it does stemming. In most cases, it only removes the suffix. Okay, so this is about stemming. Now let us look at lemmatization using NLTK. For this, we need to use the WordNet lemmatizer. So we import the WordNet lemmatizer. Okay, so we instantiate an object of the WordNet lemmatizer. So we have the words over here, programmer, program, and programs. So for each of the words, we are trying to find the lemma or the base word, right? So for that, we just have to pass the word to the lemmatize function of this word and lemmatizer object. So let us do that now. So if you see over here, the word programmer has the same lemma. Program also has the same lemma, whereas programs has become program. Okay. Now let us look at the words cats, catty, cat-like, kittens. So here, if you look at cats has become cat, catty is still catty, cat-like is cat-like, kittens has become kitten. So if you look at both these examples when compared to stemming, these words make more sense, right? The lemmas make more sense for any kind of further processing down. Okay. Now, if you look at the words better and good, probably the lemma should be same. Let us see how WordNet does over here. So if you see over here, the lemma is the same word. It is not actually able to do that better is equal to good, but this is also fine. Okay. Now let us take a sentence like programmers use programming language to write computer programs. And let's tokenize this sentence to create words. And then let us pass these words to both the porter stemmer and the wordlet lemmatizer to see the differences between stemming and lemmatization. Okay. So if you see over here, what the stemmer has done is that it has converted programmers to program, basically removed ers, basically the suffix, whereas lemmatization, it couldn't find any lemma or the base word, so it is still programmers. Similarly, programming has become program and programming. Languages has become language and languages. So this is an invalid word in the dictionary actually, right? Similarly, compute is an invalid word in the dictionary. So if you see over here, the stemming gives some kind of a root word by removing the suffixes or affixes, but the problem is that it may not be a valid word in the dictionary. Whereas lemmatization tries to identify the meaning in the context and tries to give a most appropriate word as an output or base word. For example, programs is correctly a program in both the stemming and lemmatization. In the stemming, you are not guaranteed that after stemming, the word which you get is a valid word in the vocabulary of the language. Okay. Now let us take another example over here. Cars is a good movie with many animated cars. Okay. So the cars is actually a noun over here, right? Because it's a movie name. Let us see what happens over here when we do stemming and we do lemmatization. Okay. So cars in stemming has become car because it removes the suffix, right? Whereas it is still cars over here because of the context in the WordNet lemmatization. Okay. Because it also uses the pause tag for lemmatization. Similarly, animated has become anim and animated. So again, this doesn't make sense. Mini MANI doesn't make sense. Movie MOVI doesn't make sense. Right. So you can see how it can actually stemming can sometimes degrade the performance. All right. Now let us look at another sentence, which is let's meet today. In this meeting, let us continue to discuss on what we left during the last time I met you. Okay. This is a sentence. Use word tokenize again to get the words, tokenization to get the words. And then let us see the stemming and lemmatization process for this particular sentence. So again, let's, because of stemming, it's become let. Okay. And similarly over here, if you look at meeting has become meet, whereas actually it's different. It should be meeting. Continue has become continue. It has lost its meaning over here because of stemming, right? During has become dure. Again, it doesn't make any sense. So from these examples, it's quite valid that depending upon the context, stemming may not give you good results. Okay. Whereas lemmatization can give you good results. Okay. Now it depends on further downstream tasks, whether stemming is useful or lemmatization is useful. In certain circumstances, it's better to go with lemmatization. In certain cases, what I found in literature is that for query building and other things, for word normalization, stemming was useful. Okay. Because the goal of both stemming and lemmatization is to kind of get a base word so that if you have the same word, same meaning word being expressed in different ways, you are trying to find a base word so that you can reduce the variance in the different, what you call, in the way words are expressed. Okay. Let us do lemmatization with the SPACY library. For this, you need to load the SPACY library. You also have to load an NLP model. So basically, the SPACY.load and a model name loads a model as a NLP pipeline. Okay, this model would have named entity recognition, dependency parsing, pause tagging, part of speech tagging, a lemmatization, tokenization, etc. Okay, so this takes some time. So I have already loaded the model and kept. Now here is a sentence which is programmer use programming languages to write computer programs. I pass it as a document to the NLP pipeline and I get a processed doc as an output. In the processed doc, I can iterate over words. I can print the word.txt and the lemma of the word using word.lemma underscore. Let's now do this. So here if you see programmers, the lemma is programmer, right? And then if you see languages is language, again programs is program. So here if you see the word has been converted to lowercase and its lemma has been found over here. Now let us pass another sentence like cats, catty, cat-like kittens, okay, as an input. So here if you see cats has become cat, catty and cat-like remain unchanged, kittens has become kitten, okay. Now let us look at this cars example again. So Cars is a good movie with many animated cars. So here if you see cars has become car. Okay, this is a slight difference from the wordnet which we saw over here where cars were still cars, right? And then is has become be, right? Good is still good, movie is still movie, animated has become animate, okay? So these are the lemmas of these words in the sentence based on the context of the words, okay? And they are part of speech tags. Okay, now let us go to this sentence again, which is let's meet today. In this meeting, let us continue to discuss on what we left during the last time I met you. Okay, now let us pass this sentence and see what we get over here. So let's, it becomes let, meet is still meet. Okay, meeting is still meeting, whereas in our stemming process, it used to change and there are certain pronouns for which we don't have lemmas. Okay, so otherwise, it kind of is for the met, it has given meet over here, right? So which makes more sense, okay? So in this way, you can also perform lemmatization using SPACY. But as I said before, whether to do lemmatization or stemming depends upon the use case or downstream task which you want to do. Say for example, classification, clustering, right? And depending upon the context of the downstream task, you can experiment with the stemming or lemmatization to see if it helps in improving the results. If you like such videos, like the video, please share the video. Please press the subscribe button to subscribe to the channel. Also press the bell icon so that you will get notified whenever I am creating new videos. See you in the next video. Bye for now.